Hi and welcome to the preview release of Tool version 3. For the last couple of years we have been working on a complete rewrite of Tool.io. We carried over all the good parts from Tool 2, like easy animation, presets, compositing and shader development. But we also rethought much of the user interface, the internal implementation and how to build stuff. We switched the UI framework to IMGUI for faster rendering and better widgets. This opens the way for use cases like BJing, procedural effects, or complex compute shader graphs. No, Tool 3 is not done yet. And it's not stable for production either, but it's getting there, and you can already do some amazing things with it, including building and releasing demos. So we decided to put it out there and release it at open source software under MIT license. Give it a try and tell us what you think, so we can build it together. Okay, but first let's get started how to get it running on your PC. So if you go to GitHub and go to still-scene/t3, there's the main repository. And there's not much documentation, but at least there's some documentation on how to download it. And we will run through this quickly. So one thing you need to know, as of now, we need an IDE to build and work with Tool 3. So this IDE could either be Visual Studio, Community Edition or wider. So far we haven't tested Visual Studio Code yet, so stick with Visual Studio. And you can download it from here, it's for free. You will also need to work a little bit with Git, so don't be intimidated. It's actually not that complicated, but it really helps if you take a user interface for that. And I recommend using Git fork. You can download it from here. And if you have these two installed, you can clone the repository. So you can go here, and if you already have a GitHub account, you can use your SSH key. So GitHub has like super extensive documentation on what an SSH key is and how you set it up. But if you don't have a GitHub account, you can use HTTPS. You can click this icon to copy the URL for this repository to your clipboard. And then we can switch to fork. And here, if you click to clone, it will paste the URL into the repository URL from your clipboard. For me, it's taking the last folder selected for cloning something, which is coding. And the default file should be, or the default name of this folder in this folder should be T3, which would be okay for you, but I already have a folder there. So I will take another one. And yes, I recorded many previous versions of this video. So let's clone this. It will take a while, but not too long. And cloning, meaning it's going to download all source code, all dependencies, and all the resources for the three demos we have been building with tools so far. So it's a lot of stuff. And for that, it's actually going pretty fast. So while this thing is working here, we can take another look at the documentation, because there are two more steps we have to do. So one step is, after the cloning has been completed, we have to run this batch file in the install folder. We're going to do this in a second. This will initialize the default viewports and some default file dependencies. So it's, also copying some files within this T3 file structure. And then we have to change the working directory. I will show you how to do this in a second. So let's check here. Fork did the thing, so this was fast. And we can view, where was this? I was confused by this. New repository, open file in Explorer, this is what I was looking for. And there's the install folder I was talking about, and here's the install.batch script. We are going to start this, it will take a second. And then if you go once up, I'm going to start this t3.sln file, SLN for solution. And I'm going to open this with Microsoft Visual Studio 2019. Normally you probably can just double click it, but I have multiple IDEs installed, so I have to pick the right one. And now we are going to change the working directories. To do this, we click on the right mouse button on 2.3, properties, we pick debug, and here in working directory we pick ../././.. This basically means ... stands for parent directory, and the build directory is something like t3/debug/bin or something like this. And we need the working directory not to be the build directory, but the one where all the resources are located. So if we go back here. So we don't want this directory to be the working directory, but we want this directory to be the working directory because here's our resources folder with all the nice files we want to load. So once we have done this, we can just close this panel and then press start. Sometimes it will take a while to download packages that are required. So, but normally the second start will be much faster. Yeah, it's now has compiled all the C# stuff, which is amazingly fast. And yeah, it's downloading dependency, and there you go. Now you have it running. It also comes with, as I said, partial main was the takes a while to load, but this was the demo we released this year at Revision. There are a bunch of example projects that might help you get started to see how more complex projects are being set up. Okay, and then in the next video, I will walk you through the user interface and give you a rough overview of how to work with things. And then in upcoming videos, I will be talking about how to work with graphs and how to animate stuff and how to develop shaders and so on and so on. So yeah, thanks for watching. Tell me what you think, try it out, give us feedback either as GitHub issues or you can reach out to me on Twitter or Discord. Yeah, thanks again. See you in the next video.